This is Smoothie Audio's first module, Smear. It can function as a spectral delay, a transient smear, a resonator, a morphing filter, a phaser, a percussion voice, and more. I'll get straight into it with a quick example. Here's one way to use the module. Right now, we are hearing a simple click coming from Contour 1's rising gate output, coming through unaffected. As I turn up the stages, Smear starts doing its work, and smears this short transient into a kick. Used like this, it can turn anything into a kick. I can change the frequency and the resonance to fine-tune the spectral delay that transforms the click. Smear is a module I've been working on for the past year, and I'm finally releasing a couple of them. Smear is a dual stereo 98-pole allpass filter. You don't come across allpass filters too often in synthesizers, unless you're digging deep into reverb algorithms. It's a unique effect. A single allpass slightly shifts the phase of incoming audio, and as its name implies, passes through all of the signal with no filtering.
A filter that does not filter.
But 98 poles simply means it's 98 allpass filters in series. When set up like this, their effect accumulates and becomes audible. It's similar to a spectral delay, where different frequencies of the spectrum are delayed by a different amount. Let's do a quick tour of the panel. There are two identical sections, laid out symmetrically, left and right. By default, stereo audio feeds through the in-jacks to the left stage, then into the right stage, and finally to the out-jacks. Each side has three main controls: frequency, resonance, and the number of stages. Each control has its own CV input straight above it. Frequency and resonance each have an attenuverter for the CV input with the mini-pod. The left and right sections can be used independently by turning on split mode with the button. In this dual mono mode, the left input is being processed by only the left section, and the right input by only the right section. Finally, we have a feedback control in the middle, with its corresponding CV input above. More on that later. Let's feed some white noise into it and talk about the stage sliders, which have some secret functionality. When the stage slider's LED is off, it means we are crossfading between poles. In between poles, you get complex notch filtering because of the phase differences between the stages. The panel shows the different stages we crossfade through, starting between 2 and 18, 18 and 34, and so on. The frequency and resonance controls now affect the filtering notches. If you move fast, you get these nice filtering flams. We can plug in a modulation source to modulate these. One last thing for now. The feedback knob. So far, we have only explored the module with feedback at zero. Turning up feedback completely changes how the module sounds and gets us into unique physical modeling, resonator, flanger territory. A small batch is available now from Smoothie Audio. Links are in the description. Thanks for watching, and I can't wait to hear what you create with it.